Hi, everybody. I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We are Armchair Directors.
Dead or Alive, you're coming with us.
So we're going to take a look at the trailer for the Robocop remake.
Reboot. Remake. This one hits really close to home. Robocop, the original one by Paul Verhoeven, is one of my all-time favorite movies. Literally, I watch it every single year. And I love it just as much every single year. This thing's replay value is off the charts.
Yeah.
So I was chomping at the bit to see the trailer. Trailer comes out. This thing has been vilified right from the first moment it was announced. So it's not a big surprise that a lot of people aren't happy with it. We were making fun of the poster on the Armchair Directors page. Your move, and they left the creep off because it's PG. And, you know, they're just... The old one was so violent and gory. It's just, it seems like this one is going to be really toned down. But besides the gore and the violence, it just seems kind of silly to me to have Alex Murphy mortally wounded in a car bombing instead of the horrific way he was shot to pieces by Clarence Boddicker and his gang the last time.
Basically, it just smacks of sort of sanitizing it for a younger audience, making it more palatable for the Transformers crowd.
Yeah.
That's what they're going after with this. And the original is so good because it's shockingly violent. Like, there are moments where you're like, oh my God, I can't believe how violent this movie is. But it's also got a really smart, really funny social satire underneath the whole thing that I'm sure that this movie has none of.
Yeah.
Now, we're going off a 2-minute trailer, so maybe they'll surprise us. But this looks like the Total Recall remake all over again, where they sort of missed the whole essence of what made that movie good. And they're just shining it up and making it new for all these kids who love video games.
Yep.
RoboCop in this is played by Joel Kinnaman, who is relatively new. He was on TV's The Killing, and he's awesome on that show, but he's not awesome in a way that Peter Weller is awesome. He doesn't bring that same kind of energy. He's much more of a laid-back kind of presence, and RoboCop needs to be a badass.
Yep. I've always said Peter Weller has the coolest voice in Hollywood, and I'm not going to sit here and say the old one is better because it's older. The comparisons I make are the old one is better because it's better, not because it's older. We hear him, the new RoboCop, in this trailer, and he says some of Weller's old favorite lines, and it's just kind of facepalm moments. It doesn't give me chills. Weller has such a commanding presence even before they put the modulation and the synthesizing. He has this big commanding presence.
Yeah.
He's indignant. He's barking. He's just such a commanding voice. And this guy doesn't have that deep voice. And that's what every RoboCop, the problem was with every RoboCop who ever played Robo after Peter Weller. They never nailed the voice. I mean, all the motions aside, and Weller created that performance too, the bird-like, all that stuff. But the voice, no one seems to ever be able to nail the voice.
Right.
And then you hear the horror stories about how uncomfortable Weller was in the outfit, and the guy truly did suffer for his craft. The suit, like, he was losing pounds every single day. He was dehydrated. He was a marathon runner. They specifically hired Weller for the original one because he was a marathon runner because they knew they needed someone with endurance, someone who could take a lot of punishment. This new suit looks comfortable. I mean, even without the mask up, the old Weller thing, they had to apply like 4 or 6 hours of prosthesis and makeup and all sorts of stuff to give Weller that receded hairline, the hole in the forehead where he's actually shot and killed. That creepy look where he's like just a human face pulled over machine. Whereas in this one, none of that has happened. It's just a mask over top of the actor's face. There are a few shots of a vintage looking or vintage inspired RoboCop suit in the trailer.
Which is the coolest part of the trailer.
Yeah, I like that the most, where they took the old suit and they updated it. I thought that was great. And then what happens? You got Batman, Michael Keaton going, make that shit look more like Batman. And then you get the Iron Man, Batman, hybrid black RoboCop outfit, which just doesn't work for me. Robo's a cop. He should be one of the boys in blue.
Yeah, I really don't like that they just make him look like Batman mixed with like a Cylon. I don't like it. It doesn't look as cool. But those glimpses of the initial suit in this that is paying homage to the old one looks cool. And like, I have hope that this movie is directed by Jose Padilla, who did these Elite Squad action movies that had some fantastic action, but they were like hard edge, gritty movies, and this does not look like that. I don't know what's going on with the plane in this movie. In the trailer, we see like this stealth fighter shooting some stuff up, and it just looks like video game action that's not going to grab you or be anything new. But there are a lot of people in this that I'm like, I kind of am interested because Michael Keaton, Sam Jackson,
Gary Oldman.
Yeah, and Jay Baruchel is in this. Like, there's some cool people in this movie, so I'm not writing it off right away. But when you tell somebody they're making RoboCop and they're making it PG-13, you just think, how the hell are you going to pull that off?
Yeah, I'm not looking forward to it at all because this looks to me like it drew more influence from Iron Man and Batman than it did RoboCop, which is hilarious because Iron Man 1 with Robert Downey Jr. looks like it drew a lot of influence from RoboCop. Right. So it's just kind of weird that they're drawing inspiration from each other. You know what? I'm good. I'm fine. I love the original one. I, like I said, watch it every single year. The second one is okay. Even the third one I watched recently was okay. It wasn't as bad as I remember it. The TV show isn't as bad as I remember it. You know, I'm good for my RoboCop.
Right.
I'll watch the new movie, but I'm not going to, you know, lose any sleep over it if it ends up being a steaming pile of crap.
And it's one of those things that if it totally sucks, it'll be just like the Total Recall remake, where in 3 months later, we won't even remember it happened, and you'll always still have that original movie to watch and enjoy.
Yeah, exactly. All right, we're going to tell you about our Blu-ray giveaway, our newest scheme to give away Blu-rays. It's very, very cool when you like the page and you like our videos on Facebook, so thanks a lot for doing that. But we want to give a little special extra prize to the people who share the videos on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Not just like them, but share them on their own wall and say, hey, I like these guys. I like what they're doing. Check out this video. Boom, there it is on my wall. So what we're going to do is every time we post a video on Facebook, if you share the video, when that video hits 500 views on YouTube, we're going to take all of the names of the people who shared it. The Facebook allows us to see who shared it. We're going to put all the names in a hat, and at random, we're going to draw a name. And one of those names that wins is going to get their choice of all of these Blu-rays we've got here sitting around. Been looking forward to giving them away to our fans. So don't just like the video on Facebook, but share it, and you get a chance to win one of our Blu-rays, and we'll autograph it for you too if you want.
Yeah, it only takes 2 seconds. Just do it, and you might get a free movie in the mail. You can't really beat that.
Awesome. So thanks a lot for watching, and until next time,
enjoy the show. Bitches, leave.